This PPT on effective communication skills for engineering professionals will explain how to go about communication skills for BTech 5th semester, the course on GE 6674, communication and soft skills laboratory based. The objective of this presentation to enable the learners to know the basic communication skills and to understand English language for framing for making effective communication skills with the certain video samples. Softwares used, tool used, PPT and screen casting in this presentation. We move on to the title, the effective English communication skills for engineering professionals. Introduction, to be an effective communicator in English language, the onlooker need to understand the following terminology. Number one is communication. Why English language is used. Factors affecting English learning. Language skills. We move on to the first title, that is communication. What does it mean? Communication is sending and receiving information between two or more people. Through communication, we conveyed facts, ideas, concepts, opinions, beliefs, attitude, instructions, and even emotions. Types of communications. There are five types of communication: extrapersonal communication, intrapersonal communication, interpersonal communication, organizational communication, and mass communication. Extrapersonal communication, speaking, parrot speaking, that is animal can communicate to human being. Interpersonal communication, man being a social animal, he has to communicate with others, other human beings. Organizational communication, communication is organization take place at various level, sending email, writing leave letters, sending memo. These are comes under organizational communication. And finally, we have mass communication. Mass communication is via media such as newspaper and television and etc. Barriers to communication and spoken communication, crops of obstacles or hindrance either from the sender or a receiver that mars the understanding. Noise or crosstalk, a distance from the speaker, speaker deviating from the topic, the language and accent of the speaker, speed up talking, cultural differences, physical discomforts, lack of concentration, feeling boredom. Barriers to the communication, by watching this video, we understand from the video we can understand what are the barriers that affect the communication sending and receiving. How to improve and overcome these barrier, the speaker should have watched this video, how to speak so that the people want to listen, Julian Tishers. Why English language is used in communication? English is a linked language. English simple and absence of complex rules. It is very simple, flexible, simple, making adaptation of new words, which is nearing 1 million words in English. It has and it has a grammatical flexibility in spoken communication. Just see in the example, the wrong order of the letters with the spelling mistakes can be reset easily in English. I just read out what is written on the PPT. According to your research at Cambridge University, it doesn't matter in what order the letters in the words are. The only important thing is that the first and last letters be at the right place. Reset can be a total misses and you can still read it without a problem. This is the power of the human mind. So from this PowerPoint we can understand that one of the characteristics of English language, in wrong order of the letters can be misspelled, the words can be reset easily and read easily. Mr. Ernest has defined 8 meanings of a single word by placing in a different possible position. The sentence is, I item in the I yesterday, the word only I item in the I yesterday, that means I did not slap him. I only item in the I yesterday, he did it. Third sentence, I eat only him, not any other person. I eat him only in the I yesterday, only in the I yesterday, not any other part of the hair, any other part of organs. I eat him in only the I yesterday, he has only one eye. I eat him in the only I yesterday, here not any other organs. I ate him in the I only yesterday, I need not wait today. I ate him in the I yesterday, not today. Same words used as nouns and verbs in English. Your answer is correct. Answer all the questions. Answer is correct as a verb. Answer all the questions is a noun. Watch your words is a verb. My uncle gave me an expensive watch. It's a noun. Research, research, your research, to research. So this is the uniqueness of English language. Factors affect English learning. Motivation factors, aptitude factors, attitude factors, language anxiety factors, gender factors, age factors, amount of exposure and personality factors. One can understand your motivation, aptitude, attitude, language anxiety, gender, age, amount of exposure and personality factors in English. You can easily learn that particular language. Language skills. When we learn a first language, we usually learn to listen first, then to speak, then to read, finally to write. So these are called 4 language skills or LSRW skills. Listening is a receiving language through ears. Listening involves identifying the sounds of speech and processing them into words and sentences. How we can listen? Like babies. We learn this skill by listening to people who already know how to speak the language. For a practice, you can listen to live and recorded voice. The most important thing is to listen to a variety of voices as often you can. Speaking is vocalized form of language, usually requires at least one listener. When two or more people speak or talk to each other, the conversation is called a dialogue. Speech can be flowed naturally from one person to another in the form of dialogue. It also be planned and rehearsed as a delivery of a speech or presentation. Of course, some people talk to themselves. In fact, some English learners practice speaking standing alone in front of the mirror, practice speaking online using voice or video chat and services like Skype. Speaking samples of watching this video, Malala Yousaf, a Nobel Prize presentation. Online. A reading skill is a receptive skill. Through it as we receive information. Advantage of a reading skill greatly broadens the onlooker's vocabulary or your vocabulary, helping you to speak better English. Writing skill. To write clearly, it is essential to understand the basic system of a language. In English, this is include a language of grammar, punctuation and sentence structure. Vocabulary is also necessary, as in correct spelling and formatting. How to improve writing skill? Free writing technique. Set a time limit for yourself. If you are beginning a writer, try a 10-minute limit. After you set a time limit, write, do not stop. you spell wrong words wrongly, do not go back to edit. If the idea fades, keep writing. This is a crucial exercise. Even if you have nothing on your mind, write, I have nothing on my mind, I have nothing on my mind, I have nothing on my mind. You can keep writing this over and over, it is okay. So when the time limit is finished, stop, write nothing else. Go back to the page, read it slowly, underline all the ideas that surfaced during the session that pertaining to the formal writing on which you are working. Conclusion: integrate listening into speaking, reading into writing. Be effective communicator in English. Communication is cannot thought, it is caught. References: these are the references I have taken. Thank you.